Hey folks, welcome to Market Intraday Analysis by InTheMoneyStocks.com, your leaders in pure technical analysis, avoiding all that Wall Street hype. This video for Tuesday, September 20th, 2011 is sponsored by Realtek. All right, let's get right into the mix here, folks. Market's having a solid update. This is something I talked about yesterday and actually last Friday as well. I said, hey, listen, the market's chances are will not see major selling ahead of the Federal Reserve announcement on Wednesday. The reason being, everyone is hoping for major QE3. There's got to be some sort of announcement. The market's banking on that, and that's really keeping people from selling into this. In fact, right now you're seeing more buyers. Yesterday, a lot of people thought we were going to see major selling, but I stuck to my guns, and I said, listen, I think this market comes back. And if you look at yesterday's intraday video, I specifically said when we were trading near these lows right down here, I would not be surprised to see the market reverse and close back just off the highs of the day or right around the highs of the day, and that's exactly what happened. Market again reversing back, closing right here today. We're basically back to the recent highs. If you zoom out, the pivot high from last Friday was right here at the 122 level. That's exactly what we hit today. Beautiful double top, beautiful scalping opportunity today. And again, you can see you scalp that to the downside. We've bounced back, kind of double topped, and are now pulling back as well. And right now, this is known as consolidation. Could mean there's a little bit more upside tomorrow morning before the Federal Reserve announcement. So again, just keep that in mind. It depends on where this market goes. I mean, but at this point, we're now in the trigger zone. We're now in the bullseye where the markets are all, and I mean globally, folks, globally, the markets are watching the Federal Reserve tomorrow. All right, and that will be the determining factor of where this market goes. The markets are pricing in quite a bit of QE3. That means if you don't get enough QE3, this market could literally have a down 300 to 500-point day tomorrow. Now, I think the Fed knows that, and chances are they're going to come out with a pretty big, you know, gun and take a shot at this market and try to get it going. But you never know how the market's going to react. And again, overall, I unloaded my long plays over the last week or so as this market rallied up. And now I'm beginning to look for some possibilities of some shorts. And by the way, we nailed a short today. This was a great call in the Research Center, which, by the way, you can take a 7-day free trial to the Research Center. You get full access to everything listed under the Research Center. The short call went out late last week on MCP. And the reason why, and I'll go over this trade, folks, the reason why, because I noticed that you have a trend line right here. Take a look at this trend line connecting the lows. Not only that, but price was right here trading below the moving averages. And whenever you have moving averages above current price, it always acts as a little bit of a ceiling, meaning the stock price can't get above that very easily. Now, if it was one moving average, maybe. If it was two, okay, there's a small chance. But when there's three, and see how they're all above price here, that makes it extremely impossible or close to impossible to get above, and you factor in that to the downside. So essentially what I said to the traders in the Research Center in the trade alert for a short on MCP Molly Corp is that if the market breaks through this green line, if the stock breaks through this green line, it's a dead short. Sure enough, late last week it did, and look at the results today on your short on Molly Corp. MCP is the symbol, down $10.45 right now. All right, that's almost 20%. 20% drop almost on the stock price. A monstrous move to the downside and nailing it. I mean, the money made here today, folks, whether the people in the Research Center played options or the stock itself on the short side, is monstrous. Again, just imagine being short even 1,000 shares. Just 1,000 shares of Molly Corp, you made $10,000 today. That's one call in the Research Center. Just one call. And I put out some other alerts as well that we're watching. I have an alert to buy possibly Netflix if it hits a certain level. It hasn't hit that level yet, but I have a master level on Netflix. I actually posted a new trade, which is an overall short on the market out there. If you want that, join the free trial. I mean, there's so much going on in that Research Center. I do my nightly videos. Nick does his daily market reports with master levels. We have cycle dates. You name it, it's in there. And again, 7-day free trial. Check us out. Worst thing you do is cancel without paying. Who cares, right? Free is for me. All right, in any case, markets again continuing to have a nice little move up as I called for over the last couple days. And again, now we get into the wild card day. Notice the markets are trying to break this little pivot area right here. All right, now if we break down and through this, and especially if we confirm to the downside here, we haven't confirmed below the 20 moving average yet, but if we do, you could see a little bit more profit taking into the close ahead of tomorrow's Fed. But again, I don't see a big sell-off. You're just not going to get that big sell-off until we get word from the Fed. And who knows, word from the Fed, if the Fed really is strong and understands the market, they may give enough QE3 to push this market up a little bit in the short term. But again, I think the risk here in the market, if you look at the market and you ask me which way is the risk, would it be easier to be long the market? Would that be the money play with low risk on the, you know, for a fall, or the opposite? The obvious answer, and I'll be honest with you guys, chances are There's more risk to the downside, meaning there's more likelihood of a big fall than a big move up. If the QE3 comes out and it's equal to what the market expects, markets stay flat. If it's a little bit better or better, then the markets go up a little bit more. But the markets have rallied and factored that in mostly already. So maybe you get an up 100, 200, 300 point day max. Downside, I'd be worried if the Fed does not perform here, that not only do you get 300 down, but maybe 500, and it could be a multi-day sell-off because it would probably spill over into Europe. And then Europe would create another fall the next day, and it would just be a rotational sell and a major collapse. So again, I'd be either in cash or with a minimal small position on the short side right now for the markets. And again, that's just watching and understanding the risk reward. There's really not a lot of reward to the upside, maybe one day up or 2 days up max, as opposed to the downside, which would be much, much more. Let's go to the daily chart. And the other thing I want to just point out on the daily chart, which I'll talk to my research center members tonight about, you have a longer term bear flag here, but at the same time, you haven't hit this 50. So maybe if we get a pop on the Fed, maybe we get to the 50, but I don't think much more than that. The next level after that would be probably right up here, which would be about 123.50 or so. So these are your two levels right in here. And if you get through that, then maybe, again, that's very unlikely. I think this is your probably max high area right in here. But again, just so we talk about the levels after that, then you would be looking for this upper area right up here, which would be around 126, 127. Okay? Any sort of downside, if you take out this white trend line, that's when the whole thing collapses. And that would be a catastrophic event for this market, in my opinion. And you'd go back to 110 on the spiders. All right, now let's take a look at the dollar today. Dollar is flat to lower. Interesting that I talked about this in yesterday's video as well to the nightly members in the nightly video to the Research Center members. But one thing I was talking about, we got back above the 200, but you never confirmed again. And so far, it doesn't look like you will confirm. So that actually leaves the door open for a down dollar, which could actually increase the markets a little bit on the Fed news. So again, it's really a 50-50 more than anything tomorrow. But again, I'd rather be a little short or in cash than on the long side just to protect because, again, we've had a pretty solid rally in this market now over the last week or so. All right, let's take a look at a couple other things out there. What else is moving today? Apple Computer is hitting new all-time highs, up almost $10. Fantastic surge here. Here was the previous double top. We just really blew through this on Apple. Apple continues to be kind of the darling of the markets, and it is increasing in value here. I would say you probably give it room. Maybe if it gets to 450, we start to talk about a short, but it's too strong right now to really be a key short, in my opinion. Amazon, which was a blast off, is getting a little bit of a pullback today. This stock, again, from essentially 175 now to 240. What a move in such a short period of time. It definitely needs to consolidate a little bit. And charts like this make me think that the market is probably closer to a fall than not, only because these charts are leaders and they're extended. So whenever you have an extended leader, it needs to pull back in the very least. Even if it's not a big drop in the markets, they might just need to come in just a little bit. NASDAQ overall has outperformed the S&P and the Dow by a lot. Technology, especially led by Google, you know, Apple, Amazon, stuff like that. Even Intel and Microsoft have been good performers. You can see the Qs here. If we take a look at the Qs, and I can see a lot of drawing on this chart, but look at the move on the Qs, how big of a move that's been. And then if you compare it to the spiders, you can clearly see it's not nearly that hefty of a move. Spiders are more sideways, choppy to slight up, while the Qs chart, which is the NASDAQ 100, is much more vertical on the charts here. So again, it's interesting. With the Qs chart actually makes me wonder here, your levels on the Qs, let me just bring that up here. I would say this is probably your next key area right here on the Qs. And right in this area. See this little gap area, gap window, gap fill? This is probably around 57.45 to 57.75 is your next good area of resistance. And then if you get through that, you're looking for this area on the Qs chart as your next spot at 58.75. And then ultimately double top up here would be your ultimate double top level. All right, and again, I don't really think we're going back to those double top levels. It would have to be a monstrous QE3. I just don't think politically they can do that. Even though I think they're going to do something, I just don't know if it's going to be enough for the market. And that's really what we're waiting to hear tomorrow. And for that purpose, I just want to make it clear, I may have a couple positions on the long, couple on the short, but overall it's very minor. I'm still mostly in cash, and that's the smart thing to do. You know, there's a lot of people out there that continue to kind of, you know, wonder what the market will do, whether or not we're heading to recession or not. And again, the Fed will probably say positive things, but again, it's hard to imagine they'll really come out and blast, all right? All righty, guys. Let me just see if there's anything else I want to talk about right now. Citigroup, let's take a look at Citigroup. Citigroup down. Again, financials down today, or at least a little on the weaker side. Even JP Morgan with the Dow and NASDAQ and S&P all sizably up. I mean, Dow's up 134. JP Morgan should be up more than 15 cents. And again, that shows us relative weakness in the financials right now. Bank of America's just up a penny on the day as well. Now it's flat. Now it's actually down a penny as I watch it tick up and down, up and down. So something to watch there. All right. Let me just take a look here. Google up 8. Very nice day on Google. Baidu flat. Interesting little drop. But we talked about Netflix earlier, but Sina had a big drop today. Look at this collapse on Sina. One of the pretty impressive collapses. Went from about 111 all the way down to a low of about $95. Tremendous drop in such a short time. Had a big bounce though, but then has come back in since then, and something to watch and something to follow here in the coming days. MasterCard up 11, American Express. So we're seeing the credit card players doing very, very well. 2 to 3%, even close to 4% gains on Visa there, and that's another strong sector. All right. Alrighty, guys. So, having said that, that's all that I'm seeing for now, and we'll go and see how the rest of the day treats us. Come take the 7-day free trial to the research center. Come take the 7-day free trial to the chat room, and let's start profiting with the pros. Take care.